Again to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. Okay, so today I share with you a project that I'm working on for a client, right? Now this is the one of the thickest glasses I've ever worked with in building aquariums. I built several aquariums for several clients, but I've actually chosen to use a half inch thick glass to build this 70 gallon aquarium. Now this aquarium, as you can see, this aquarium has no, what you call it, braces, right? Now if I had braces, several things probably might be of an issue, one of which would be to actually get the top section fitted neatly at the top. When I say the top section, I'm meaning the hood, right? So I did not actually include construct this aquarium with any braces. But note, the aquarium itself is 18 inches from the base, right? So being that it is 18 inches from the base, it's not that tall in comparison to this aquarium, which is 2 feet from the ground. It's built from 1/4 inch glass. It's one of my worst mistakes, my worst design I've ever made, as a result of it being 2 feet off the ground by 4 feet 48, right, 1 inch wide. This is a 60 gallon, right? What happened is that I've had this front piece here actually broken apart. Where should I say? Yeah, practically broken apart about 3 times. One, the first time it actually broke apart was actually shot. I was actually, when I say shot, I mean I actually had it on film, right? I was talking about it and it actually just broke, right? It should not have been so high with this thickness in glass. The glass should at least be 1/2 inch, right? It broke again. I had 2 Oscars in it and they had a fight, and the braces were on it, but they fought so hard that they actually, you know, the strength of the Oscar actually broke the glass, right? Now this aquarium is divided into 2 with another piece of 1/4 inch glass in the middle that actually serve as a means of strengthening the frame, or should I say strengthening the glass itself, right? So I have braces here, and here, right, along with the center piece. Now in reference to this aquarium, I do not need any brace because it is not that tall off the ground. Another thing is that the glass is, and the density of the glass makes it fits very well on the silicone. You know that silicone works best under pressure. So with this pressure being experienced by the silicone on the glass, what you find is that it tends to actually weld together neatly, quickly, and you don't have the glass actually bending, because the amount of water that will actually go into the aquarium will not be of the volume that will actually cause the sides to actually bend, right? Or should I say actually break, right? So in going forward, I decided to actually design this aquarium. This is a 70 gallon aquarium build. I mean, it's a 73.9, right, in volume, but you know, we wouldn't really full up to the 73.9, so I just call it 70 gallon, give it probably about 1.5 to 2 inches away from the top, would be a 70 gallon, right? And this aquarium, you will see everything put together in a few days, where in which my client, I know that he feeling much pleased about this particular project. It's far from done. I have the cabinets to make, filtration, decoration, purchasing of the fish. I'm not sure if I'm going to be placing in it. And of course, the one of the most difficult parts, to actually clean it and get it delivered. This is Riley here for another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica, right? I hope that this video was of value to you. Throughout this video, I stressed the point that the thickness of the glass can determine the height. And if you go out on a limb and actually try to build a high aquarium with thin glass, what will happen is that you'll end up with disaster like what I had experienced a few years ago. Thank you very much for stopping by. Have a wonderful day. Peace out. Catch you next time.